Hey guys, what's going on? Flipotaku, and today we're doing my manga first impressions for Ultraman. Stay tuned. Ultraman is a manga being put out by Viz under their signature line, and it is written by Ichi Shimizu and illustrated by Tomohiro Shimaguchi. Now this duo, if you guys have watched my channel before, might sound familiar. They are the duo behind the Get a Robo D Evolution reboot. And I gotta say, Viz, thank you so much for putting it out in the signature line, because the artwork pops on these pages. But this duo's first big breakthrough in Japan was with their work Line Barrels of Iron, which was a mecha series, which we never got manga-wise in the States, but we did get a pretty okay anime adaptation by Studio Gonzo between 2008 and 2009. And it was all right. It wasn't anything special, but it was okay. It was pretty enjoyable. Get a Robo D Evolution was my first time hearing about the duo, really, and when I was reading it, I was having a blast. Now, as much fun as I had rereading Get a Robo, because Volume 4 is coming out soon, the duo doesn't capture the heart of the original as well as I first thought. But I have read this, even though it's the first impressions, I'm rereading it for a full review because we are completely caught up with Japan volume-wise. 12 volumes are out total. I believe they passed 3 million sales worldwide, which is a huge thing, because Ultraman, especially in the States, is very niche. So, you know, thank you, Viz, so much for putting this out. But they do a better job because they have more time to flesh out the story, the characters, and the lore. And Ultraman does a really good job of straddling the line between a reboot and a sequel, because it is technically a direct sequel to the original Ultraman TV show, which, by the way, I know I'm going off a tangent again, Milk Creek Entertainment, they got the rights for the whole Ultraman franchise, and in October they're putting out two regular Blu-rays and then two steelbook editions of Ultra Q, which is technically the first group of episodes in the Ultraman universe, and then the original Ultraman series. So I'm super excited about that. But as a huge Ultraman fan, especially growing up, I've always been into Tokusatsu, and Ultraman and Super Sentai have a special place in my heart. So going into this, I knew a lot of the previous lore, and they do a good job at, if you know nothing about the franchise, you can go into this manga and have a great time. It does a really good job establishing the previous lore briefly, while also setting it up for modern times, which I think is something that's really hard to do. A lot of reboots failed to execute what made the original so special, and the duo does a great job doing that. Now, the main character is the son of the original Ultraman, even though when the Ultraman being, which is I believe called the Warrior of Light, left him, his memory left with him, but he got the Ultraman genes, which he then passed on to his son. So his son is like a high schooler, but he's got super speed, super strength, and eventually aliens come back down to Earth and he becomes Ultraman. And it does a really good job showing him that he, even though he does have the suit, which is awesome, by the way, you can tell that they definitely are inspired by the Avengers and by Iron Man. And even, some old school fans were kind of lukewarm on that. I thought it was pretty awesome, even though I feel like the Marvel stuff is a little stale now, that this still feels like it's very much a Japanese property and still very much Japanese influenced. And the art just is phenomenal. Like I said, this duo knows how to design mechs, they know how to design suits, and it's just awesome seeing this group of Ultramen fight out different monsters. I don't want to show too much artwork because, you know, it is a Viz property and people have been copy-striked for showing off panels. But let's show you guys a couple panels real quick. Here is one. I love the artist's just kick-ass designs here. And let's see if we can get one more shot. Oh, by the way, Viz does include the badass color pages. So yeah, you guys are probably thinking, man, that's straight up Iron Man, and I felt that way too, but it definitely feels like its own thing later on, especially as you get further along into the story. Now, this is just the first impressions, and my first impressions are highly recommend. You guys should go pick this up. And it's really sad because when I watch haul videos, when I watch reviews from friends, no one is talking about the series. No one. Every time I go to Barnes & Noble, I believe the same copy has been up there for at least a year because the top part's all yellow from the light. I don't see this selling that much here in the States, at least. They have topped, I think, 3 million sales worldwide, so that's awesome that it's doing good. And it's, you know, Ultraman's a very niche property here, stateside. But it's beloved over in Japan. So, you know, thank you again, Viz, for putting this out, because we would have probably never gotten this if this wasn't for you. And I'm really glad that we did, because Ultraman kicks ass. This kicks ass. This is fun, guys. Go pick this up. And when I'm further along in the series, when I get caught up to volume 12, expect a full review so far. So the way I'm going to start doing my videos is I'm going to be rereading everything in my collection, especially with vacation coming up. I'm going to have so much time to just sit down and read manga. I'm going to be doing first impressions for the first handful of volumes and then a full series review. So, you know, expect it for 20th Century Boys and Doro Hedoro and Golden Kamuy and stuff like that. But guys, this is one of the best ongoing mangas of 2019. Seriously, this is such a blast, and it deserves more attention, it deserves more praise, and it deserves to be in your collection. Anyways, guys, I'm Flip Otaku. Let me know what you guys think down below. Are you guys picking this up? If you are, let me know what you think. If even if you're not a Ultraman fan, let me know what you think of this if you're a fresh fan going in. Anyways, guys, I've been Flip Otaku. Let me know what you think about the intro, what I'm doing with the channel, I'm trying to make things more professional, quote unquote. But I still just want to be behind the camera, just going off the top of my head. Anyways, sorry for rambling. I'm Flip Otaku, and I'll see you guys next time.